Hi, Michael Duker back with you again for reed making the economical, fast, and wonderful way using a Dremel drill and among the other tools, some that I've shown you in my earlier video. For starters, what you didn't see is the wrapping, and once the reeds have dried out, then that's what they look like. On the drying board, I make a bunch at one time and I let them sit for as long as I can, and then I tighten the wires and I use hot melt glue. And many of you might question that. In fact, I had a former colleague look at the hot melt glue and say, "I'd never do that." And I asked why, and he said, "Because it's not traditional." Well, the string is sealed up with Duco cement, which is poisonous and which Harold Goltzer proved to me creates a brick wall so hard right here on the reed that it keeps the reed from vibrating, that you have to compensate for that binding. So I have avoided for over 20 years the hot melt, the string binding, and I use hot melt glue. And I was introduced to it by David Sog in the Pittsburgh Symphony. I asked him online, "Can you instruct me on this?" And in a very humorous and sarcastic but friendly way, he said, "Yeah, plug the glue gun in, point it at the cane, and pull the trigger." That's what I've done. And as you can see, it's colored glue. It works great. It is ready to go. It is waterproof, airproof, a little bit flexible, but it holds the reed tube in a stable configuration. And then I do what I showed you last time. I clip the tip using my wondrous tip clipper, and I go at it with the Dremel drill, creating a tip and working on the rails. And now I see that I need to do a little bit more on this rail and this one with the Dremel drill. So I'm going to do that. Here we go. And I hope you're noticing that I haven't butchered anything yet. It's good to do a demo that works. And the skill is a result of years of practice. So don't be discouraged when you use that Dremel drill. Now then, I know for a fact that the heart of my reed right here is very heavy. The reed is not playable right now. So I'm going to thin that. And also the body of my reed through here is rather thick. So I'm going to go here, and I'm going to go here, and I'll show you how I do it. I wet up the reed. This is really the first time that I've got it wet, and I like this technique with the knife diagonally across into the corners. By the way, I really love the way this fits into my hand much better than the so-called reed knife. So I'm going this way, and then I'm turning it, and I'm doing the other blade. This is done frequently, I would say by most bassoonists, with files, but I'm too impatient. And I like the knife. I feel comfortable. I'm going to blend that in. I'm being careful not to hit the rails. And let's see what I've done. I use the dial gauge. Let's find out Here's the before at about 20, just behind the tip. It's 22 thousandths of an inch thick. And what I've just done brings it down to 15. So let me do the side which I haven't touched with the knife yet so that I can balance the reed. Blending it in. You notice that I've not gone into the back of my reed yet. And now let's check the thickness of both sides. About 16 thousandths of an inch. About the same. At a measurement of 1/8 of an inch from the tip. Now, the middle of the reed, 30 thousandths. And the reed's not going to play yet. And so, this is where I become the human profiling machine. I'm going to bring down that middle of the reed somewheres around 20 thousandths, 25 thousandths of an inch. And here goes. It's just long scrapes with my wonderful Stanley utility knife on that side. On this side. The tip is way too open, so I'm going to squeeze at the first wire. I've had some students recently try to open or close the reed here. Don't do that. Go at the first wire. And that looks like a pretty good tip opening. Let's see if it works. How about that? Before I try the reed and test it on the bassoon, I want to make sure that the wires are tight. We can get into wiring of the reed in an entire session all by itself. Harold Goltzer, one of my wonderful teachers, was very adamant about the importance of the wires, and I agree. In any case, I'm going to tighten this second wire. I'm going to make it so that I can bend it. I'm going to tighten the first wire, which eventually I will probably replace, but for our purposes right now, it'll be fine. I'm going to check the tip opening one more time. Let's give it a try.